Assalamualaikum scholars, you are listening to Ziaur Rahman. Scholar, today we have lecture number 30 and it's part 8. Today's lecture is about how organizational knowledge is created. First, we are talking about the knowledge creation. Knowledge creation is the formation of new notions and concepts. When something is first time comes under the observation of the humans, at the same time, some of the knowledge is created. Any addition in the existing stock of body of knowledge, it means that there is a knowledge creation. When anything comes first time in the observation of the human, or when anything added in the existing body of knowledge available on the earth, it is called knowledge creation. What is organizational knowledge? Organizational knowledge is the sum of all kinds of knowledge contained within an organization that can provide business values. For the organization, everything is determined or measured in the term of what this thing is provide a business value to the organization. So for the organizations, knowledge creation and organizational knowledge is mean that what the new thing or what the existing things provide values to the organization. It is available in the form of rules, regulations, policies, SOPs, processes, formulations, production schedules, qualities and skills required for in the company. So all these are the forms of organizational knowledge. There are many other forms. I have highlighted some of the forms just to show that what are the forms of knowledge creation in the organization. In the organizations, knowledge creation is mostly available in the form of a practical knowledge or a technical skills. So any practical knowledge or technical skills which are available in the organization in any form, either in computer generated form, in ICT's form, or in human skills forms, so it is the organizational knowledge. Organizational knowledge, this is I am talking about the importance and the reason of the organizational knowledge. Organizational knowledge offers an opportunity for increased awareness about knowledge requirements in the given organization. It ensures a sound delivery of quality outputs and services and promotes growth and sustainable business. The ability to create new knowledge is often at the heart of the organization's competitive advantage. So, to increase the awareness about the organizational requirements, to ensure the sound delivery of quality outputs for sustainable and growth of the organizations, and for competitive advantage, organizational knowledge creation is important. These are the three importance for the organizational knowledge creation. There are four sources for organizational knowledge creation, and these are called perception of the individuals, memory of the individuals, consciousness, and reasoning. These are the four sources in the organization for knowledge creation at the individual level. So when the individuals perceive something, memorize something, consciousness about something, and create reasoning about something, so they can create, these individuals in the organizations create knowledge in the organization. These basic sources create knowledge and creates justified beliefs. These four sources either creates knowledge or creates justified beliefs. So these are two different things. These four sources may create the organizational knowledge, or may these create the justified beliefs. Then at the organizational level, these are the four sources. At the individual level, being a employee, being a owner, being a higher management, being a middle management or a lower management, being a individual in the organization, these are the four sources of the organization. And these are the organizational level five ingredients for organizational knowledge creation. Number first is intellectual properties available in the company, owned by the company or known by the company. Product knowledge, lessons of failures and success, conferences or customer communications. So these are the five ways through which the organizations can learn from its own system, from its own environment about the knowledge creation. So organizational knowledge creation is also possible through collaborative practices. Number one is practice, collaboration, integration and organizational education. While organizational knowledge creation, sometime tacit knowledge is converted into explicit knowledge and sometime explicit knowledge is converted into tacit knowledge. So what are these two terms? You are requested to please see our previous lectures in which we have provided a very detailed lectures about tacit knowledge and the explicit knowledge. So in the organizations, the conversion of explicit knowledge into tacit knowledge and tacit knowledge into explicit knowledge happens occasionally, time to time, as per the requirement of the knowledge creation. So the next lectures are about the difference between organizational knowledge and academic knowledge. What are the four types of knowledge? Declarative, procedural, contextual and somatic. What is empirical research and what is research based evidence? So these are lectures which are very important for the scholars. So you are requested to please listen all these lectures which I am hopeful that increase your basic understanding about the concept of knowledge creation and what is knowledge and how the knowledge is important for research purpose at MS level, MPhil level or PhD level. So these lectures will provide you the basic understanding about the empirical research and research based evidence. Further, if you have not subscribed to our channel, you are requested to please subscribe it. If you like our videos, please click on bell icon. So please click on the like button and click on the bell icon if you want the notifications of our every new videos. Thank you very much.